wasting way. This is then the way for ages, and worse this night since the First World War arrived. We have been seeing many organizations established to solve this situation that is in the world. Not only the world, but the problem of the unrest of the so-called Negroes. Many have failed, and some are still failing. Why? Some say, or have said, they have some good ideas according to their way of life, but they will not prosper in their way. Why? The so-called Negro does not consider there is a cause for his effect. This so-called leader tries to blame the so-called white man, which is his brother by nature, for he states that poverty, ghettos, politics, low jobs, segregation is the cause of his downfall. This is a lie. I will prove this in the future from the Bible when I give the scriptures. They have great politics, they have big politicians such as John Arliss, Ellen K. Davis, Ellen Brown, Charles Caldwell, and Aaron Russell, Revealed Manson, Russo, Bruce, and many others. They say segregation, but they do not realize God is a segregation. If not, why did he give nations different languages? I will say this, the individuals of all nations will integrate sometime or another, but not as a nation. Nations do not integrate. And it is written years ago, these people would be hated of all nations. They have fight to the point now that they do not want to obey the higher power. It is time now that you, being the higher power of this world, should get the least of these organizations together to hear the truth of their cause, that they may show their people their fault of the things they have to do to enlighten them, that they may stop this ruthless sway they have. And if they do not want to do that, let them receive the consequences that is written, because their unjust ways are hurting the good of their people, for I see and know there is a great silence stirring up. Now is the time for you to stop it, if they will hear. I am sent to show the way of peace, as it is written, blessed is the peacemaker. Selah. Now, I'm going to take the scriptures and show you this world was given into the hands of a certain man, which is called Esau in the Bible. Some people call white man, but he's not a white man. If we will look at him and see that he's not a white man. But he's Esau, Edomite, which is in the Bible. Now I want the young man to give me the scriptures, Job 9:24, and we'll see that this earth was given into the hands of a certain people. The earth is given into the hands of the Gentiles. See, it says the earth is given into the hands of the Gentiles. Well, since the earth is given into the hands of the Gentiles, he is the higher power in the world, and we should obey this power. Give me Romans 13:1. Let's see. As it will tell you here, that every soul must obey this organization. Let every soul be subject unto the higher power, and the Caucasian people is the higher power of the world today. Alright? For there is no power but of God. For there is no power but of God. The powers that be, the powers that be, ordained of God, is ordained of God. Alright? Whosoever therefore, resists the power, resists the ordinance of God. You don't resist the ordinance of the establishment, you resist the ordinance of God. See, because God has given this man the world. When we have the world in our time, under King Solomon, David, and all down there, we disobey God's law, and God has made his Bible and has given it into the hands of our brother. And they that resist shall receive for themselves damnation. This is why when we sing do not want to obey the law and say when the cops grab them and beat them, they want to say it's the brutality. But the Bible has told us, you should obey the higher power because it's no power but of God. I know when our civilization comes into power, all nations are going to obey us. In the same way we should obey the man now with the hands that we're in now. Rulers are not a terror for good works. No, if you do good, this man is not a terror to you. All right, you know, but to the evil. But to the evil, yeah, when you do wrong, he knows what to do to you, all right? Will God then not be afraid of the power? Will God then not be afraid of the power? Do that which is good. Do that which is good. And thou shalt have praise, and thou shalt have praise of the same. For he is the minister of God. He is the minister of God. For you for good. For you for good. But if God do that which is evil, and if God do that which is evil, be afraid. Be afraid, for he bears not the sword, and bears not the sword in vain. For he is the minister of God. He is the minister of God. A revenger. A revenger is to execute wrath. Execute wrath. For him that doeth evil. That's it. Now, as I have said before, the scriptures have pointed out many things about the so-called Negro, which he does not know, but we're here to try to enlighten him on these things. Now, he is not a Negro. This is another lie that's been taught. He is not a black man. This is another lie that's been taught. He is not an African. This is another lie that has been taught. He was a nation of people when he came to this land, and he's been destroyed from his identity. Give me Psalm 83:3. Let's see. They have taken crafty counsel. David said, Lord, they have taken crafty counsel against his people, all right?
And consulted against thy
hidden one. And the so-called Negro is a hidden people. Nobody knows him by the nationality. They call him all colors and a race. This is different names like this, which is no effect. They have said,
come and let us cut them off.
They come and let us cut them off
from
being a nation. Now this was done through slavery. And you're not a nation today, but they all these nations have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation. Why?
That the name of Israel.
Well, Israel.
There'll be no more
in their remembrance. And it's not in your remembrance. Nobody remembers that. Well, you would cut off being a nation. That's why they call you a race. And by color. All right.
So they have consulted together.
All these nations have consulted together. That word of God don't lie. If God said these words, these people have consulted together to keep you from being naked. You believe the word of God. The word of God don't lie. The Bible calls that let every man be alive. And God's word. As it is written. With one consent,
they are confederates against
you.
The tabernacles of Edom.
Edom is the so-called white man. They call white man, but it's not. It's the Edomite. We can take you in the Bible and prove it. All right.
So Ishmaelite.
Those are people of India. Israel of India. Moab is the Chinese.
The Hagarene,
those are the people of Egypt. Ammon is the Japanese.
The Philistines,
those are people of Africa.
And the inhabitants of Tyre.
Now, he mentioned these nations, which have been stuck together to keep you from being a nation. Now, I'm going to get you into the book of Deuteronomy to prove to you that you are the Israelites. And I want to read it again for the 28th chapter of Deuteronomy. Start from the first verse. Read that. And it shall come to pass. Start from the first verse. Read that. And it shall come to pass.
And it shall come to pass.
Thou shalt hearken to Israel.
hearken diligently
unto the voice of the Lord,
unto the voice of the Lord thy God,
to observe,
to observe,
to do all his commandments,
and to do all his commandments. You see, we have commandments to do. And observe means to do them the way it was told to you to do it.
All right?
Which I command you to
which do. I command thee this day,
that the Lord thy God,
the Lord thy God,
will set thee on high,
will set thee on high,
above all
of our nations. Okay, now you see, a lot of people are trying to say, no, we can all be the same. You can't have a whole lot of heads. One's going to be the head of the world. And we find our brother Esau, the so-called white boy, he is head of the world today. Now when he falls, for his disobedience, okay, then his brother Jacob is coming up to rule the next world. All right, you know.
But it shall come to pass,
but it shall come to pass,
if thou will not hearken,
if thou will not hearken
unto the voice of God,
unto the voice of the Lord thy God,
to observe
what doeth,
to do all his
commandments,
and his
statutes,
which I command you,
that command thee this day,
that all these curses
shall come upon you.
Now let us see now these curses
that is on the so-called Negro, is on nobody else but them. On thee are the children of Israel. These curses shall only be on the children of Israel. Nobody else, because they disobeyed God's law, and they said, God is turning back on them. And God said, in their affliction, they will hear. So, all right, let's see.
Cursed shall not be in the city.
Cursed shall you be in the city. So-called Negroes are cursed in the city. They can't move where they want to move back, and they can't go in the state. Bad prophets would go into certain places, get there a few days, so that they come up now, try to open the place. Schools they can't go in. This is a curse God put on, all right, you know.
And curses shall not be in the field.
And field, all fields of endeavor you curse. You the man hires first by all these things. It's on the so-called Negro, which is the real children of Israel, all right.
Curses shall be thy basket and thy store.
Curses shall be thy basket and your store. The Negroes wondered why they couldn't do this. They would say this was the cause. We don't patronize one another.
Well, every effect is the cause.
Why don't we patronize one another? This is the curse that God said. You wouldn't prosper in your stores. All right, read on.
Curse should be the fruit of thy body.
Shall be the fruit of your body. The fruit of your body is your children. Your children born in the world, they don't know the nationality of them. Don't know the language of their faith. They go through the same predicament that your grandparents went through and your parents brought down to the day. All right, read on.
Curses shall not be when I come to fill.
Curses shall not be when you come in the world.
And curses shall not be when I go out.
Be when you go out of the world, yes. You're born, nigga red, nigga this. With no nationality about you, though. All nations about the nationality here. I don't care where they come from. They speak about their nationality. And the so-called Negro doesn't know, because these nations are consulted to keep you from being a nation, that the name of Israel will be no more in your remembrance. I'm going to tell you this word, Israel. They say they take you, go to your father now. Yah means he, father is men, and all stands for Allah. He's a prince of Allah, a prince of God, if you want to say it in English. And this is what it is. We're princes. God is the king of the earth, and we are the princes. But look at us down here today. You wouldn't think you were anything. All right, read on.
The Lord shall send upon you curses.
God's going to send upon you curses. See the Negroes curses, and the white man, the man, all this, that, the other, because their leaders have done this. All right, read on.
That curses, that.
Yeah,
and review.
And review.
But all that thou
said, all that he put his hands to do,
all shall thou be destroyed.
All shall thou be destroyed. And he is destroyed. He's the last chief of the house of Israel. He's destroyed for the lack of knowledge. Hold on a minute and get me holy 4 and 6. Let's see if he's not destroyed for the lack of knowledge. My people, I said, my people,
I destroyed
for the lack of knowledge. Lack of knowledge. See, they don't know, all right?
Because thou hast rejected knowledge.
He has rejected knowledge. He rejects knowledge from his side and wants to follow the customs of other people. All right,
I will also reject you.
God said, I will also reject you.
But thou shalt be no
free to me. See that?
Then thou hast forgotten the law of thy God.
See, thou hast forgotten the law of your God.
I will also forget your children.
God said, I will also forget your children. This is what has happened. All right, go back to the 20th. out to you.
I tell you, I command you.
Yes, you do. Yes,
come out to love.
Yes, that's it. All right.
The answer might be with a conception.
Yeah, we have the conception. We have hands, all these things, somatics, and all these things. God doesn't fit you with these things. This is all. All right, read on.
The answer caused you to be smitten before thine enemy.
God said he's going to be caused you to be smitten before your enemy. Do the white man jump on you, beat you, kill you, do whatever you want? You can see this. They fit you in all these things. God is going to be his place on our people. All right, read on.
That's what God's one way against them.
Yeah, you can go out one way against him.
And flee seven ways before
them. Flee seven ways before them. Down south, during the time when they had this cover down there, they went out one way against the white man. And when the white man come up with his bow, dogs and all that, they had to flee seven ways. All right, read on.
And thou shalt be removed into all kingdoms of the earth.
Yeah, and thou shalt be removed in all kingdoms of the earth, which they are. All right, read on.
The Lord shall smite you with madness.
God's going to smite you with madness. That's why you're mad. God will smite you with this madness. All right, read on.
And blindness.
Blindness. Blindness of understanding. You don't understand why this is on you. All right.
Astonishment of heart.
And astonishment of the heart when you do anything. All right.
And thou shalt droop at noonday.
Thou shalt droop at noonday.
As the blind.
As the blind. Thou droopest in darkness. Yeah, you're drooping now. Got no job to be found. You have no stuff in these things. God puts his punishment on you. Until you return back into him, then all these things will be eliminated.
And thou shalt not prosper in thy way.
And thou shalt not prosper in your way. I told the so-called Negroes years ago, they're not going to prosper in their way, and they will not prosper in their way. They might come up a new way, but it's going to fail. It's going to fail. All right, read on.
And thou shalt be only oppressed.
Thou shalt be only oppressed. The only people who are oppressed in the land is so-called Negroes. Africans or anybody else can come here, and they're not oppressed. The so-called Negroes, the only one oppressed in the land. All right, read on.
And spoiled evermore.
And spoiled evermore. See, that's your spoil. You want to give me this, give me this, give me this. The children ask for things. Men create things. And if you return back to your God and create these things, the God has said, the nations are coming over to you, God said, and they won't be with you, see. Teaching them your way, we know God in you. All right, read on.
And no man shall say.
And no man shall say. They've had Daddy Gray, divine, now they got another guy called Muhammad, and all God's saving, and all these ministers God's saving, so-called niggers. Now, they're not going to save you. Now, they're out there for money. That's all. God put the curse on them too, just as well as the rest of them. All right, read on.
Thou shalt be turned for wife.
Thou shalt be turned for wife,
and another man shall lie with
you. Oh, yes, when you home, you have lies about man running with your wife. Down in the south and doing the slavery time, anybody runs with your wife, you can take it. Not only that today, even today when you marry a young lady, gets mad at you, she goes off to the lover. There you are, see, there's some man's gonna lie with. Before when we home, we had certain laws. If a man runs with another man's wife, the folk should be put to death. This is out of the question now today, because you're in captivity. All right.
That's a building house. And thou shalt not dwell there.
You're going to build a house, you're not going to dwell therein, because the other people are going to dwell in the house. You might build it, but another man's going to dwell in it. Same way down south, in good slavery time, they built all them plantation houses for the boss, this, that, the other. And just think the man that you built the house for, you put these meals and everything, and yet he does not want to live beside you. Isn't that something? Isn't that something? God said in Numbers 23:9, let's see what God, hold on, let's see God said in Numbers. Yeah, this is all in the scripture. Yeah, see why you don't want to live beside you. Let's see. Numbers 23:9. Yeah.
From the tops of the rock,
all those men fly from the tops of the rock.
I see him.
All right.
But from the hills I behold.
The whole hills I behold. Because God put this curse on you to be your stuff.
come back to him, and you're not going to be recognized among the nations. I know the right man is doing exactly a lot of good to you now, but God said he's going to cause the enemy to treat you well in the time of evil and in the time of affliction. And this time of evil time is in the world today. Look at it. Evil could come upon this man. God said, if thou shalt not know from whence it rises, thou shalt not put it off. And it gives the so-called nigger a good job now, because he wants this year evil to pass from him. But God is doing it. All right, you know. Thy sons and thy daughter, thy sons and thy daughter, shall be given unto another. Yeah, this is during slavery time. The children were taken from the so-called niggers. One was sold in Tennessee. One was sold up in Virginia, different parts of the country. And the mothers didn't see their children. What does Scripture say?
And then I said,
and there shall be no
hands over
the night. Get their hands to get them back. All right, read on.
The poor of God's land,
the fruit of your land,
and all thy neighbors,
all your neighbors,
shall a nation which thou mayest not eat up.
That's right, the fruit of our land, the neighbors, all the people ate all the stuff up that we grew. We didn't have nothing to do. Get it out of them, got it.
And thou shalt be only oppressed.
Thou shalt be only oppressed. Nobody else, all right, read on.
Oppressed the way.
And crushed the way, that's it. All right.
So that thou shalt be mad for the sight of thy
eyes. That thou shalt be mad for the sight of your eyes. That's what you're mad now, because the white boy's got everything and you haven't got nothing. You wonder why is this now. All right, read on.
And thou shalt bring you.
God's going to bring you.
And your king.
And your king.
Which you shall set over
which
you.
Which you shall set over you.
Unto a nation.
Unto a nation.
Which neither thou.
Thou.
Nor thy father.
We didn't know this man. We didn't know this man of Arthur. The ship, the slave traders brought up here and sold it to these people. These people didn't actually bring it here. It's here. No, there were slave traders that were down along the coast and went over there and got you from the Africans. The Africans sold you to them. And they brought you here and sold it all along the coast. So don't blame this man for taking you captive. So, all right, read on.
And there thou shalt serve under God.
There you're going to serve under God. See, you can serve in Baptist, Methodist, Catholic, Holy, Sanctified, Muslims, and whatnot, have you got. If you didn't serve them, you served the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob when you were home. But now you forgot that God now, and you serve another God. All right.
And thou shalt become an astonishment.
You're going to become astonishment, yeah.
A prophet.
Proverb, yeah. They don't want you. They don't know what to do with you. They don't want you. You hear them on the television, different times, say, send them back to Acts. Send them back to Acts. What did he want? What did he want? See? All right, read on.
And a Bible.
And a Bible. The Bible is for the niggas, spoons, jacks, jacks, boogies, and all this stuff in the world, see. This is the cause. This is the Israelite. All right, read on.
That should be your sons and daughters.
That should be your sons and daughters.
And what thou shalt not control.
Thou shalt not enjoy them, no. They've taken some of them sent to the army, to the war, to go out to kill somebody that hasn't done anything to the people. Now, I know in our land, Israel fought many people. But God said, in the law, no paragraph. No paragraph means do not murder. And war is murder. When you premeditate how to kill somebody that you have never seen, this is what you call murder. We had a law, we had another word, we killed people that done that wrong, but that was murder. But this war is murder, and you see it today in Vietnam and all these places. It's nothing but murder. Killing innocent people, people that never done nothing to you. And the nations are going to be what they sell. Most that eyes are lying to quickly. But you find in the New Testament, Bible calls that be not deceived, for God is not God. But whatsoever a man does, that shall he also be. If he's done good, he's done be good. And if he's done bad, he's got to be something. You don't get anything in this world for nothing. You got to pay for everything that you get. All right.
The stranger that is within you,
the stranger that is within you,
shall get up upon you, go
away. Even the strangers from the year coming here, where these people have been here 400 years, and they get the birth of so-called, they go very high. All right, read on.
And thou shalt come down very low.
You shall come down very low, which the Negro does. All right.
He shall lend to you.
All the strangers going to lend to you. And you find here now the strangers can lend to the Negro. They got loan shops, banks, and all this thing. And the Negro has to go there when he gets something. He is the real Israelite. When he had it, God said, you didn't appreciate it. And now I'm going to give it into the hands of another nation now to provoke you to jealousy. All right, read on.
Thou shalt not lend to him.
And you can't lend it. No, Negro can't lend to nobody. No, all right. to be the tail.
Right, you're going to be the tail. And you can look around and see the so-called Negroes, Puerto Ricans and the Cubans and whatnot are the tail, all right?
Moreover, all these curses
shall come upon you
and shall pursue you
and shall pursue you
and overtake you.
And overtake you. We'll pursue you, nobody else, and overtake you, all right?
Shall not be destroyed.
Shall not be destroyed, all right?
You know? That shall happen not unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
For if it happeneth not unto the voice of the Lord your God,
to keep his commandments,
keep his commandments,
and his statutes,
what he commanded,
which he commanded you. And they shall be upon you.
All these curses are going to be on you
for a sign.
The sign is that you're an Israelite.
That's all. All right, read on.
For a wonder whether you're going to get out of it. All right.
And upon that,
and upon your children. All right.
Forever.
Ever is just a dispensation of time. It didn't say eternal. But forever is a dispensation of time. All right, read on.
Because thou servest not the man thy God.
Joyfulness.
And with the
heart of the heart,
for the abundance of all things,
he has given us, all right, you know.
Therefore,
thou shalt serve thine enemy.
Therefore, you're going to serve your enemy.
What's the righteous thing?
Yes, God put this man against that tribe in the beast.
And you're going to serve him for the one of everything. If you want your water, you've got to serve him to get it. If you want clothes, you've got to serve the man to get it. And if you want your puppy clothes, soft things, the whatnot, ties, and all these things. You've got to, and you're looking to, you've got to serve this man for the one of everything, all right? We all have to serve this man because of his will. And you got to serve him for the one of all things. I have to serve him. I'm here now doing something right here, but you have to serve the right man to do these things. All right, read on.
And he shall put a yoke upon him.
He's going to put a yoke on
upon thy neck.
Upon thy neck.
And so he has to serve.
That's what they have done. The yoke of iron was the Roman citizen they put on. The Roman back was the Roman citizen. And there is a leg of iron. Daniel saw this image. The head was gone with the Babylon. The breast, the two breasts go with the Medes and Persians. Then it comes down to the leg, which is the Roman. All right.
The Lord shall bring a nation.
God's going to bring a nation
against you.
Against you.
From the end of the earth.
From the end of the earth.
As quick as the eagle flies.
Just as the eagle flies.
A nation whose time thou shalt not understand.
Yeah, we didn't understand this language. No, we didn't start to understand this English language, all right, we don't.
A nation of fierce confidence.
A nation of fierce confidence, all right.
And shall not regard the person of the old.
No, did not regard the person of the old. No, it didn't.
Nor show favor to the young.
And no, show favor to the young. Ready?
And ye shall be left few in number.
We're going to be left few in number. Well, I told you this great tribulation is coming in the world. This great war is coming in the world. I can go through the Bible and show you. Many of you remember when Khrushchev said he was going to marry the American people. Well, it's in the Bible that Russia's going to bomb America. It's in the Bible. And I can take you in there and show. And we don't know when the time, but they're going to bomb America. All right? Do you think for an instance, here's a people that killed out 45 million people called the Indians and took their land and set them in a reservation. God gave those people their land. It was one of the tribes of Israel. They had left home 3,000 years ago and settled in America, in Cuba now, Puerto Rico, and the Mexicans. They had settled there. And now the Spanish come over here. And the American English people come over here and take it away from these people, the land that God has given to these people. Now, I wonder how would they feel if the other domination would go into Europe and take this land and set them in the reservation, which land God gives to the European man. I know they wouldn't like it. So this is the time the children have to pay for the sins of their fathers, like we have paid the sins of our forefathers. Where is he? Where has the stars of heaven? Yeah,
God has earth. The stars of heaven and multitudes. Because thou wilt not obey the voice of the Lord thy God.
Thou wilt not obey the voice of the Lord thy God. That's the word, all right?
And it shall come to pass.
And it shall come to pass.
That as the Lord rejoiced over you to do good, and to multiply you.
And multiply you.
So the Lord will rejoice over you
to destroy you. That's it.